Okay. So I will be speaking on OCT imaging in bifurcations PCI. Let me, at the outset, let me first extend my gratitude towards my transradial mentor and my very, very, very dear old and very old friend, Dr. Shigeru Saito, for inviting me for this particular meeting. And secondly, I also want to extend my gratitude towards my friend, Dr. Akasaka, for all my OCT understanding, you know, what I practice. About 50% of our intervention high in India, and we are exploiting, you know, this modality to the best of patients' interest. As of now, for bifurcation, we have done many, and in left main bifurcation, we have a series of now 52 cases, and a significant number of cases of LAD diagonal and obtuse marginal arc bifurcation, as well as PDA PLV. The understanding of bifurcation, this paper has been very important paper. It was published by Okamura from Japan way back in 2014 in Euro Intervention, which had cleared about link connecting carina and link free carina, as well as distal crossing and proximal crossing and the consequences with the different designs of stent, that is PIC2-Whaley and PIC2-PIC design. And we are following, you know, this particular concept very much with all our cases, particularly left main bifurcation cases. And I will be throwing few cases, you know, for what we have done, a few of the good cases: 66-year-old gentleman, hypertensive, diabetic, class 3 angina, fair LV function, LMCA trifurcation, Medina 111, syntax 428, plan, mini crush followed by kissing balloon. This was the case. And after mini crush and kissing balloon, this was the result. And you can see this was actually link free carina and distal crossing. We did not consider much about a small ramus, which you can see, which is up to a little bit jail. But this origins of circ looks very clean. And this is because it was distal crossing. And it was a 54-year-old gentleman, hypertensive, LV function, LMCA trifurcation, again, Medina 010, LV diagonal bifurcation, Medina 111, syntax 419. This was the case done during last trico, provisional T for LAD diagonal bifurcation as well as LMCA bifurcation case. We did it. We did kissing balloon, and we avoided stenting the diagonal. Same thing, we avoided stenting the circumflex artery. And you can see here, this is the left main. It was again a distal crossing and a link-free carina. That is a small ramus, which also shows a reasonably good lumen. This is the diagonal origin, which is actually having link connecting carina. And after doing some work, this is the picture, looks reasonably good. Another gentleman, 52-year, diabetic, dyslipidemic, family history. This patient presented with us with hyperacute anterior wall MI, severe LV dysfunction, LMCA bifurcation, Medina 111, syntax code 32. Again, on intra-aortic balloon pump, we planned PAMI, mini crush with kissing balloon. Here, you know, we did everything, but we did not bother about crossing distally because it was an emergency. So we just recrossed, and the kissing balloon was done. And here you can see the OCT finding at the end. Fortunately, it was distal crossing and link-free carina and clean result. A fourth gentleman, 72-year-old, hypertensive, diabetic, non-ST elevation, ACA, spare LV function, LMCA bifurcation, Medina 111, syntax code 24, plan, mini crush followed by kissing balloon. This was a case which we did it very systematically. It was a pretty stable patient. final, after many curves, final kissing, and she took run from both ends, left main, LED to left main, circumflex to left main, before and after. And you can see this was just before, and this is after crossing. It was a proximal crossing. And this was the LED origin, which was clean, but this was circ origin, where you can see there are some struts there because of the proximal crossing and link-free carina. So, but still a good acceptable result. Another gentleman, 82-year-old male, hypertensive, diabetic, dyslipidemic, NSTACS, symptomatic moderate LV dysfunction, Medina LMCA bifurcation, Medina 111. Now, this was a surgical case because he already had a proximal stent edge stenosis, which was extending into left main at the circ ostium, syntax code 24, but patient point blank refused bypass. So, reluctantly, we accepted this case with mini crush followed by kissing. Here again, there was not much of the relevance crossing proximally or distally. We just wanted to remove the struts from the, ostial region and wanted to make a clean flow. So, mini crush followed by kissing balloon was done. Angiographic result looks excellent, but this is what is the OCT. There are some artifacts. But you can see this was LED to left main run. Circumflex looks reasonably good. There is good amount of crowding of double stents in that region. And this was a LCX to LMCA run. And there you can see, because the LED stent was protruding in the left main, there is some amount of crowding there. There are some artifacts. But, this was the best possible work we can do on him. Patient is doing all right now at the end of 9 months. This was a 59-year-old female, diabetic, dyslipidemic, unstable angina, normal ventricular function, left main bifurcation, Medina 111, syntax code 26. Mini crush followed by kissing was planned. This was the final kissing and the end result. And there you see it was a proximal crossing. It was a pretty, patient had ongoing pain, so we had no time just to make sure that it is proximal or distal. So this was just simply the, after doing the work, we took the final runs of OCT. And you can see it is a link connecting carina and proximal crossing. And that's why there is some crowding, you can see, but a good lumen. 75-year-old male, hypertensive, diabetic, class 3 angina, fair LV function, left main bifurcation, Medina 111, syntax code 29, mini crush followed by kissing balloon was planned. Again, a very complex left main, mini crush was done, kissing balloon was done, and result looks reasonably good with some sort of under expansion of proximal LED thought, but on OCT, it was not all that bad, but it was a proximal crossing, and here in this fly-through view, you can see some struts hanging in that region of the circumflex origin, and here you can see this reconstruction image. There is some strut, but still there is a good lumen, and result was acceptable. Clinically, patient is doing good. A 65-year-old female, diabetic, chronic stable angina, normal ventricular function, left main bifurcation, Medina 110, syntax code 19. Provisional T-stenting for left main bifurcation was planned. Again, a very complex case. And actually, patient was in the refusal of surgery. But somehow, we managed with our strategy. And this was, again, a link connecting carina and, again, a proximal crossing. And that's why there are some struts hanging there. Another case, 70-year-old female, hypertensive, diabetic, NSTACS, normal ventricular function, LMCA trifurcation, Medina 111, small ramus and small circ, syntax code 2. Of left main. Here you can see there was a small end, hanging at the clear that I don't want to touch. I want to just make sure, because RCA was dominant, I wanted to make sure that a left main to LED flow becomes perfect, and this is what we exactly did. And here you can see, you know, it's a jailed sort of ostium which we did not touch. This was the case, which was a very complex 33-year-old, a young man, actually a surgical case, but again refusal done during the last live demonstration cycle, but last case by us. And left main bifurcation medina 011 plus LAD diffuse disease and circumflex 90% lesion and syntax code 32. Here, what we did is we first tented the circumflex and then we reconstructed LAD. You can see the whole LAD endoluminal reconstruction was done. And after doing that, this is good LAD flow by using two stands there. Then we crossed the struts. And then we opened up struts and did the kissing there, and we did not deploy the stent, and this was an acceptable end result. Here you can see, you know, before we did the final kissing, and this was the final result, which was to me acceptable result. Again, it was a link connecting carina, although it was a distal crossing. Another case is a 73-year-old gentleman, diabetic smoker. Now, this was an ongoing anterior wall MI, severe LV dysfunction, left main bifurcation 111, and mid LAD stenosis, high syntax score, LAD stenting followed by mini crush of LMCA bifurcation was planned, LAD stenting was done, mini crush followed by final kissing was done. Here, because it was acute MI situation, ongoing anterior wall, we did not bother about distal, we did not insist upon distal crossing, and we could get a reasonably good result, but here you can see it was link connecting carina and proximal crossing, and good amount of crowding there, but this was acceptable in that emergency situation. And this is the last example I am showing, a 50-year-old gentleman, again an anterior wall MI, diabetic hypertensive family history, left ventricular dysfunction, LMCA trifurcation, syntax code 27, again mini crush followed by kissing balloon was planned. In these situations, we don't bother much about ramus if it is small or moderate size. Only if it is large size, I will use three wires and do lot of instrumentation. Because ultimately what you need is to make major part of to revascularize the major part of coronary system, and this was the end result. Again, because it was ongoing anterior wall MI, we did not insist upon distal crossing, and we just did the final OCT check. Again, it was a proximal crossing and link connecting carina, and this was the end picture in the fly through view. So we are heading on with a very large series of left main bifurcation under OCT guidance, apart from other bifurcations. And as of now, we are already done with 52 documented cases of left main bifurcation. And maybe now we are taking follow up for it to be published in a very high impact journal. Thank you very much for your kind attention.